coming down the aisle from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
He was completely dedicated to wrestling.
The most popular champion in wrestling history.
He wanted to be the best.
I always wanted to be like Bruno Sammartino. Just the impression that he had on me, as the way he carried himself as a man.
In my opinion, he's the greatest champion that WWE ever had. Ever.
Immigrating to America from Abruzzi, Italy as a young teen, Sammartino utilized his storied physical power in local strongman competitions, earning the moniker of strongest man in the world during his time. The Italian powerhouse soon captured the attention of local professional wrestling promoters. And the rest, as they say, is history.
He was so big, strong, powerful.
Not only was he powerful, but he was resilient. After breaking his neck at the hands of arch-rival Stan Hansen, Sammartino returned to compete just 3 months later at Shea Stadium, proving even a broken neck couldn't keep the living legend down.
In order to be on top, you have to be a winner. When you train hard and you have that confidence of yourself, you don't think about losing, you only think about winning.
On May 17th, 1963, the Italian Superman shocked the world, defeating Buddy Rogers for the WWF Championship in an astonishing 48 seconds.
Mr. Ray, you're looking at a great champion!
Sammartino's dramatic victory would be the beginning of an historic title run of nearly 8 years, a record that stands to this day.
Tremendous ovation for Bruno Sammartino, one of the most popular individuals in the world.
It was in the world's most famous arena, Madison Square Garden, that Sammartino established himself as a box office icon, headlining 187 MSG sellouts.
When you fill up Madison Square Garden, you're more than a name. You are a part of those people. They came to support him.
He packed Madison Square Garden year in and year out. I think that statement alone explains his greatness.
As a consummate professional and dedicated family man, Sammartino was a role model to millions all over the world. The reigning champ was even honored a private audience with the Pope in the Vatican.
Bruno Sammartino was my father's favorite performer, was his father's favorite performer.
A powerful gentleman and someone who carried the championship with pride and honor.
While Bruno's cumulative championship reign of 4,040 days is arguably his most impressive accomplishment, it pales in comparison to the living legend's stature. For in the 1970s, and even today, no name resonates more in the world of sports or entertainment than that of Bruno Sammartino. It is with great pleasure that we induct the living legend into the WWE Hall of Fame.